Have you ever had liquid stick to your piper tip or drip out of it? Pipetting volatile, oily or foaming liquids with high accuracy and precision can be very, very difficult. To do it right, you need the right tools and techniques. That's why in this video, we're going to take a look at a few examples of challenging liquids and show you a few tips and tricks to increase your reproducibility for your experiments. Let's go. We'll be using an Eppendorf Explorer pipette and a Multipad E3X multi-dispenser to show you how to deal with volatile, viscous and foaming samples. Let's talk about volatile liquids first. Have you ever had liquid drip out of the pipette tip as soon as you pull it out of the sample? If you're using EP tips, dripping usually happens because your sample has a high volatility, like ethanol. These liquids evaporate easily, which causes the air cushion to expand and push the liquid out of the tip. Let's look at some tips on how to deal with this problem when you're using the Explorer pipette. First, use the pre-programmed adjustment setting for ethanol or an individual adjustment setting. Secondly, use the reverse pipetting mode. And lastly, pre-wet the pipette tip at least 5 times. However, if you want an easy way to work with volatile liquids, it's best to use the positive displacement tool, like the Multipad E3X. You don't need to make any adjustments or change the pipetting technique or even pre-wet the tip because the instrument doesn't have an air cushion to be affected by the liquid. Is your sample thick with a high flow resistance? If so, it's probably a viscous liquid like glycerol, blood or oil. The usual challenges with those are air bubbles inside the tip, liquid slowly flowing out of it, or liquid remaining inside the tip after pipetting. Before we talk about those and how to solve the problems, it's important to remember never, and I mean never, cut off the pipette tip. That will always lead to inaccurate results. With an air cushion pipette, the best solution is to adjust the pipette to the liquid. Use the reverse pipetting mode and pipette slowly. Of course, the ideal choice for pipetting viscous liquids is again the positive displacement system. With syringe-style tips, you can easily pull liquid into the tip and push it out without leaving any residue. And here's a pro tip. When you're using highly concentrated glycerol, it's best to use the visco tip. It's specially optimized for that liquid. What about foaming liquids? Examples of common liquids that foam easily are master mix, liquids that contain detergents like Tween 20, and liquids that contain proteins. Because foam builds up, these liquids often stick to the inner wall of the tip or create splashes when they are dispensed. With an air cushion pipette, foaming liquids are best pipetted by working very slowly using the reverse pipetting technique. If your sample contains a detergent, we also recommend that you use low retention tips. Naturally, the best choice for foaming liquids is again the positive displacement tool. So let's summarize. Here are the key points. The best choice for pipetting any liquid is the positive displacement system. The reason these tools aren't the only type used in labs around the world is the price. Tips with an integrated piston are much more complex and thus more expensive than standard pipette tips. When you're using an air cushion pipette, an electronic one is best because it's easy to adjust and it comes with a reverse pipetting mode and adjustable speed settings. If you upgrade to connected electronic pipettes, you don't even have to remember which settings are ideal because the pipette manager can do all of that for you. Isn't that great? Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you again in the next video.